So, I am on the 6th train heading up down to my late professor's office. It's like light years off of campus, don't ask me why. I'm sandwiched in between this guy who's literally drooling at some European hipster. Well, let's be honest, smells Woody Allen from Gershwin in the air. When he flopped Manhattan, well, I'm not so impressed. I hear like Philip Glass at best. I wish I could take a second to get home. My whole thesis, which I need to write like now. I don't remember the Muppets getting hives when they took Manhattan. My own diagnosis says I'm creeping towards psychosis because I cannot find a place to get calm. It's really hard, you know. I tried to take up yoga, but you'd be surprised how many folks don't think deodorant is zen. I even saw a life coach who told me I should breathe. Just breathe. But every time I took in a breath, I visualized that life coach's death. She's having lunch at Cafe Pierre, and she's choking and choking and choking and choking till finally she's calm. I'm sorry, anyway. I get to my professor's and he sits me down and tells me that my thesis on Virginia Woolf is somehow false. I tell him what I'm working from is not so much a thesis, but and she went crazy, which seems, well, apropos. My professor just tosses back his head in a dry Manhattan. I'm wondering which will kill him quicker, the Big Apple or the liquor. When suddenly I panic and I tell myself I must get someplace calm. I up and run toward Penn Station. I swear my head was ready to blow. A train to Jersey just as fast as any person can. The 90 minutes out, I get off at some provincial hamlet I've never heard of. There's a real estate office right on the block. I can afford a 2-bedroom. I go into shock. I think, what the heck? I write a check. Cause there's sunlight and closets and laundry, but mostly it's calm. Like Times Square at 5 a.m. calm. Like totally freak me out calm. Like I'm gonna slowly go crazy and throw myself off of the balcony calm. Damn it. So, I tear up my deposit and I head back to Penn Station. Of course, the subway's broken, so I walk 4 miles home. And like 14 hours later, I get back to my apartment with my crazy spastic roommates and a room full of my own. I've got this black and white poster on my wall that says my Manhattan. And I give it the finger. But I let my gaze linger, and I notice how the people look like tiny specks of gray, all haphazardly arranged, just like they were in that Monet. And suddenly I'm struck by this bizarre revelation that, like Warren's whacked out theory, might deserve some exploration. I sit on my bed.